This video is made possible thanks to the lovely sponsor down below, SALH. Thank you so much for your support. Hello everybody, it's DreamInMind here. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. So you thought that Kanagi was next, so did I. But instead we got surprised and the goddess is already descending upon us. Let's go over her stats, connect Magias and team and Memoria recommendations. Ultimate Madoka is a limited light magical girl, and as a 5 star she has a max HP of 29,143, a max attack of 9,114 and a max defense of 7,906. Ultimate Madoka has the 3rd highest HP out of all 5 star light magical girls, and her HP is still quite high when compared to the other 5 stars. Her attack is quite high when compared to the other 5 star light magical girls and the other 5 stars. Finally, her defense is average to high when compared to the other 5 star light magical girls and the other 5 stars in general. She is a ultimate type, and her growth and leveling is focused on her attack and defense. When taking a look at her discs, we can see that she has one charge disc, one horizontal and one vertical blast disc, and two excel discs. Her MP gain is great. From a excel charge excel combination, you can earn around 42 MP. Let's move on to her Connect EX skill and Magias. Ultimate Madoka's connect is called Sorry I Took So Long. Depending on the rarity, she increases the damage of the targeted ally for 25 or 40%. She will increase their resistance towards status ailments with 100% and removes the current status ailments. Finally, she also has a 70% chance to apply the Survive buff, which becomes a guaranteed at her 5 star rarity. If the buff is triggered, the ally will receive 20 HP back. Ultimate Madoka also has a special EX skill called Prayer for Salvation. She is the first magical girl to receive this kind of skill. At the start of the battle, the whole team will receive a HP regenerate buff for 2% and for 3% if the skill is max limit broken. She will also increase the team's resistance towards status ailments for 20% and for 30% if the skill is max limit broken. Her Magia No Need to Despair Anymore deals damage to all enemies. As a 4 star, she will deal damage between 340 and 380%, and as a 5 star between 360 and 400%, depending on Magia level. She will increase the attack of all allies. As a 4 star, this is between 25 and 35%, and as a 5 star, between 30 and 40%. She will increase the blast damage. As a 4 star, this is between 15 and 25%, and as a 5 star, between 25 and 35%. She will also increase damage on charged discs and MP gain on XL discs. As a 4 star, this is for both between 15 and 25%, and as a 5 star, between 20 and 30%. Finally, she will also give everyone a damage cut. As a 4 star, this is between 25 and 35%, and as a 5 star, between 35 and 45%. All these extra buffs will last for 3 turns, and their exact strength depends on Ultimate Madoka's Magia level. Ultimate Madoka has a second Magia attack instead of a double. Her Magia, I'm With You Always, will deal 902% damage to all enemies. She will increase the attack and blast damage of all enemies for 45%, increase their charge damage and MP gain by XL discs for 35% and gives them a 50% damage cut. All these buffs will last for 3 turns. Honestly, I kind of rushed this review. When we got the news, I immediately started working on it. And I hope I won't let you guys down. However, I do think that most of you already know that Ultimate Madoka is great gameplay-wise. She is literally God. So I think most of you will pull for her regardless. If you have enough gems, that is, because I guess not many expected that she would come this early. But anyway, Ultimate Madoka's HP and attack stats are great. Her defense is pretty decent as well. This means that she can take on several roles in a team. You can use her as one of your main damage dealers or a off tank, besides already using her as a supporter for your other team members because of her great connect, EX skill and Magia. Her EX skill gets activated at the start of the battle and lasts until the end of the battle, so even if she somehow gets defeated, the buffs will stay on the rest of the team. Which means that your team will constantly be healed, making certain memorias like those days are gone possibly less attractive to use. You can also still use the memoria because the heal will stack, so you get healed more each turn. And naturally this gives you a stronger heal, so if that is what you're looking for, go ahead. Her second buff will also help out a lot. Ultimate Madoka will increase the stats ailment resistance of your whole team for 20 or 30%. This will naturally help you out a lot during challenge quests, where bosses love to spam status ailments. If you want to max limit break the skill, you'll need to pull her 4 times and 4 slot her. Her connect is also great because of the damage buff, which is on par with any damage buff coming from a 5-star magical girl. She will remove any status ailments, meaning that she removes statuses like curse, burn, fog, and binds. And she will also help out the rest of the team with their survivability. However, to be sure that she does so, you will need to awaken her to the 5-star rarity to be sure that she will apply the survivability buff. So if you apply the survivability buff to an ally, and that certain ally keeps getting hit by the enemies that turn, her HP won't go down any further than 1 HP. And after the turn ends, 20 HP will be restored. And as expected, her magias are also great. She takes care of both offense and defense. Not only does she give everyone an attack buff, but she also enhances all discs and, mind you, all for 3 turns. The percentages might not be as high as Kyoko's increased blast damage, for example, but no matter who you put in the team or what kind of disc RNG you get, you will always deal much more damage to your enemies for at least 3 turns. So in that way, it is still a very useful buff. And above all, you will also get a 3 turn damage cut, which is on par with normal Madoka's damage cut buff. Finally, should you use Ultimate Madoka in PvP? Well, why wouldn't you? She will automatically heal your team and increase the status ailment resistance of the whole team, which can be extremely useful in PvP. It renders memorias which have a certain chance of landing status ailments, like going out in a kimono and I will protect this perfect body, less effective. And above all, Ultimate Madoka has great stats and a connect. You might wonder in what kind of teams Ultimate Madoka works, but you can better wonder in what kind of teams she doesn't work. She works great in both Blast, Excel and Mixed teams. Literally every other magical girl will just profit from her presence, because she can basically do everything. So, sorry to say, but I don't really have any team recommendations, but I can offer you some nice and fun team recommendations for hard quests. Of course, this is just my opinion, but naturally, I guess Double Ultimate Madoka speaks for itself. You can also combine those two with either Iroha or Normal Madoka. Sadly, we still can't awaken Iroha to her 5-star rarity yet, but she does become a lot better when she finally gets uncapped. Anyway, since Ultimate Madoka doesn't heal a huge chunk of HP like in one go, Iroha can be your healer for the two and possibly revive any of the two in case you didn't have the survivability buff up for them. Normal Madoka doesn't have a revive ability, but she can help the other two to get their Magias up faster and heal them. Furthermore, she also has the same damage cut ability. Considering that it also lasts for 3 turns, you probably won't take a lot of damage. Another fun option is to put Ultimate Madoka together with Iroha and Kokoro. Now you already know what Iroha does, so I won't say it all over again. But Kokoro will obviously be the tank of the team. She has a damage cut on both her connect and Magia, and also the counter buff on both her connect and Magia, although it's only a small chance that the counter will activate in those 3 turns after she performed her Magia. Still, it is another nice team, especially if you have Memorias that allow Kokoro to taunt or guard the others, so that she takes damage for them. Finally, Ultimate Madoka can also work greatly with Sayaka. Sayaka is already hard to defeat, but Ultimate Madoka can help her to go even further and beyond. Sayaka can also further increase Ultimate Madoka's heal with her own connect, and once again, just put a taunt or guard Memoria on Sayaka and you're probably good to go. I know that these aren't really like my usual team recommendations, but I hope that these kind of quote-unquote team recommendations can help you out in tougher quests. So, if you already play JP, what is your favorite team to use Ultimate Madoka in? If you don't, in what kind of team would you like to use her? My favorite team with Ultimate Madoka in JP is combining her with Sayaka and Hareki Sayaka. Ultimate Madoka's personal Memoria, A Bit of True Hope, will remove all debuffs on herself, which means that she removes any negative stats like attack, defense and Magia downs. The cooldown on it isn't too bad and it can be a good Memoria to use in challenge quests, where debuffs happen. Other good Memorias are My Bible and I Made Friends. They will both increase Ultimate Madoka's attack even further. The boost from My Bible is slightly higher and it makes Ultimate Madoka fully immune to the cursed status ailment. I Made Friends also gives you the chance to land a critical hit each time you attack. Another option is to use In the Light at its birth. This Memoria is in the same gacha as Ultimate Madoka, so there is a decent chance you might get it. Anyway, this Memoria also gives her a attack boost and it has a 75% chance to ignore a evade. If you max limit break the Mamoria, there's even a 85% chance. So this can definitely be useful in challenge quests or in PvP. The Mamoria Food Stall Paradise is also decent. It will enhance 4 of Ultimate Madoka's 5 discs. It increases blast damage and MP gain from Excel discs, so this Mamoria works for both blast and Excel teams. If you want her to be a bit more of a tank, you can use Sunlight Shining Down. This Mamoria gives a permanent defense boost of either 22.5 or 30% and a 15 or 20% chance to guard and therefore protect a ally from a enemy attack. So by giving Ultimate Madoka a slight defense boost, she can further protect your allies if that is what you want from her. Just to be honest, there are many Mamorias which work great on Ultimate Madoka, but I don't want to make the video too long, so leave any other suggestions in the comments down below. I just only mentioned a few, okay? So if you weren't already convinced that Ultimate Madoka is great, I hope you are now. She is definitely worth pulling for. She is great in story quests and challenge quests alike, and just makes a great addition to any team. So, are you pulling for Ultimate Madoka, or are you not, and are you staying strong for someone else? Feel free to let me know down in the comments below. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please leave a like and subscribe if you did. You can also join our Discord server and follow me on Twitter. Links are in the description below, as well as my Magia Record player IDs if you wish to follow me. If you want to keep up to date with what I'm exactly doing, I highly suggest you follow me on Twitter or keep an eye out on my community posts, since I'm really trying to make more use out of it and keep you all updated. Or just join the Discord channel, that would be nice. Have a good morning, afternoon, night, or whatever your time zone is, and I hope to see you next time. Bye bye!